In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Mautic marketing automation platform to set up sort of your traditional autoresponder, where your traditional autoresponder is when someone gives you their information, you send them an email, and then maybe 3 days later you send them another email, and 5 days later you send them another email. This typical autoresponder, I'm going to show you how to do that with Mautic. Now, one of the things I love about Mautic is it has this visual campaign builder, which is actually pretty cool, and I hope over time it just gets better and better and more options are added to it. But as it stands right now, it's probably the most powerful thing that I've ever used. So I'm in a Mautic installation right now. If you don't know how to install Mautic, I've got a video on it on how to do it properly, and you need to make sure that you installed it properly, because if you didn't, a campaign will never get triggered anyway. So I've got a full complete video. I suggest you watch that. It's here on my YouTube channel or over on my website at adampreiser.com. Sorry to interrupt this video. When I originally recorded it, Mautic was on version 1.3.1, and since that time to now, they upgraded to version 1.4. They released version 1.4, and with that release included different terminology when you are in the Mautic application. And so this is a good point for me to just interrupt this video and show you some of those changes, and then I'll continue on with the video. So one of the main things they changed was some of the terminology. So for instance, before you would see leads, now it's been renamed contacts, which you see right here, and some other items have been moved around. So we've got campaigns, that's the same, it's still right there. Underneath components, we now have a drop down that includes assets, forms, and landing pages. And then under channels, we have emails, and that's where you set up all your various emails. So there's been this little rearranging and change of terminology, included a bunch of other really neat updates, but these are the changes that you need to know as you continue to watch this video. So this video is going to continue showing you Mautic as it was at version 1.3, even though the installation that you might have today has new terminology. Back to the video. So what we're going to do is click on campaigns right here, and we're going to create a campaign. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that. If you're doing this, you're going to first want to create your emails. And so let me click on emails real quick. I'm going to click on new, and I'm going to go ahead and click on new template email, because this is going to be a template that we're using. It's not a, the difference between a template email and a list email. A list email is an email I want to create right now and just send to my list, okay? A template email is one that I'm going to set up and use through all these campaigns, or maybe use when someone signs up to a form. That's going to be your template email. So I'm going to click on select. And I'm going to say welcome. So whatever, right there. You're going to type your email content right here, right there. And we'll give it an internal name. We'll just call it email one. But that's a little too generic, because you're going to find over time you're sending, you're creating lots of email templates. So email one isn't descriptive enough. So you might want to have some internal acronyms you use. You can drop it in the category right here, publish, blah, blah, blah. This is the email. Let's click auto-generate, so it auto-generates that. And one thing about emails you never want to forget is right here, you got to click on that advanced tab and make sure you put the right from name and from email address. And that's because if you're anything like me, I have one Mautic install and I'm using it for like 5 or 6 different websites I have. I'm dumping it all in there, so when I send you an email out, I want it to come from the right website. So if it's my personal blog, it'll just say my name. If it's my company website that I collected their info, and that's what this autoresponder is, I want it to be adam@whatchamacallit. So you want to always make sure when you're setting up a new email, you go in here and you put that in. If not, it's going to take the settings from your that you created in the settings of the app itself. So anyways, I'm going to click on save and close, and you're going to see now when I click on emails here on the left, I have this one email. So now that we have this email set up, now we need to actually create the form that someone's going to give us their information. That's their pathway into the system. So go ahead and click on forms. Now I already have this one form I created for a video on how to add pop-ups and things like that on your WordPress site and then have the information get passed into Mautic, and that was using a plugin called Thrive Leads. So I've got my Thrive Leads form here, but see, there's two different types of forms, and this isn't the right type of form for a campaign. So let me show you what those two types of forms are by clicking this new button here on the top right. There's a campaign form and a standalone form. Now that form I showed you was a standalone form, so it won't show as an option in the campaign builder. But a campaign form will. And so what a campaign form is the special forms you set up where when someone puts their info in, they're immediately put into a campaign. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and click on select, and let's call this campaign form. Campaign form. Right now, right here for successful submit action, you choose what happens to someone when they give you this information and the forms collected it. So they'll probably be on your website, and you can choose for them to remain there, have a success, a display message like success, or redirect to like a thank you page or something like that. I'm just going to click on remain it form. That's fine. I don't usually give a description. Now what you want to do is click on fields, and in fields you need to add your name field, your email field, or whatever fields of information that you want to collect. So you might want the first thing you ask for is a name. So I know for me I'd ask first name and email. So that's what I'll do in this form. So we'll do this little drop down here, and we're going to click on text. And this is going to create the text field for the name. So I'm going to call it first name, like that. And then right here where it says lead field, this is where you're going to match this up to an actual field in a lead record. So if I click on that, I get this drop down, and I'm going to choose first name. So whatever someone puts in this field, put it in the first name box right there. I'm going to click on add. And then the next thing I'm going to want is email. So in the dropdown, I'm going to choose email. I'm going to label it email. And when I click on lead field, I want to verify that it's linked up to email, which it does automatically. And there it is. So I'm going to click on add. Now I've got my two fields, which is your first name and your email. And you can have as many fields of information that you want, whatever makes sense to you for your business. I'm going to click on save and close. And now when I click on forms, you're going to see I now have my campaign form and that other standalone form. You know what? If you have a long list of forms, you know it's a campaign form when you got this little box here and you hover over it and it says is a campaign form. There we go. Okay, so now we can finally go into campaigns. I don't have any set up, so I'm going to click on this new button in the top right. You want to give it a name and you want to be descriptive. So let's just call this Lead Magnet A Autoresponder. So you can make it say whatever you want to describe it. Now, before you can click the save button, you actually have to build out the campaign a bit. So the way you do that is you click on this Launch Campaign Builder, and this is where we're going to go ahead and set up our sequence of emails. So when you're in this campaign builder, it's pretty amazing that they offer this powerful visual campaign builder, and it's a joy to work with. And I've never worked with anything so powerful before, because most email autoresponders, they're not that user friendly. They're not that fun to use either. So first you need to put in a lead source, and this is basically how someone gets into this campaign. Well, we already created that campaign form, and that's what we're going to use right here. Now, what lead lists are is you can create lists, well, they're called smart lists, based on criteria of leads. So if you're using tagging, you could say, I want to create a new list for everyone that has this tag, and then you can drop all those people automatically into a campaign. But that's not what this video is. It's your traditional email autoresponder. So I'm going to click on campaign forms. And I'm going to go right here. And when I click on it, it's going to show me a list of all my campaign forms I've created. And I've only created this one campaign form right there. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and click add. And now we have this right here. And you can move this wherever you want. It's like a visual page builder. And there we have it. So now when someone puts their info into that campaign form, they're getting tossed into this campaign. So now what we want to do is we want to have some actions. And this is going to be a traditional email autoresponder. So what your next action usually is going to be is to send an email right here. So I'm going to click on that. And it says send email. And we can call this email. How about first email? And you can name it whatever you want. It doesn't matter. You can have it be what makes sense to you. So for this, let's click on wait. And then let's have it go and get sent 5 minutes after the lead is put into this campaign. I'm going to choose my email right here. Now you saw we only created the one email, but you'd want to create your entire series of emails. So I'm going to click on email one. So now when you look at this, it's saying we're going to call this action first email. It's going to be sent 5 minutes after their info gets put into the campaign. And we're going to send them this email one. I'm going to click on add. So now it shows us the email that we created that's going to go out after 5 minutes, and I can move this wherever I want. And what we need to do is we need to connect it to the entry point here. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this yellow, and I'm going to link it right there and let go. And it says wait 5 minutes. Okay, so we're going to put that right there. Now I want to send an email to them 24 hours after they got into this campaign. So I'm going to click on send email again. And let's just call this second email. And I'm going to wait 1 day. And I'm going to choose that same email because I have to choose one, but you would have a different email pre-written. And I'm going to click on add. And here's my second email. So let me just maybe put it right next to it. And here's where a lot of people get it wrong that are trying to figure this out. They think this second email needs to go here and it needs to be connected to the first email. That's the wrong way of doing it. We want to connect it like this. Pull off from the yellow again and connect it there. So now we've got our email that goes out in 5 minutes and we've got our email that goes out in 1 minute. Hey, I just had an idea. I wonder if we can actually go sideways like this. I never thought of doing it this way before. I guess you can go like this too. Or maybe like that. How about that? Okay, there we go. So we know this is going out in 5 minutes and this is going out in 1 day. Let's just add one more because I think you get the point. So I'm going to click on send email and I'll just call this third email like that. And I'm going to do wait. And let's just say we want to send this out a week later. So there isn't an option for weeks. So we would just put 7 days. We'll choose that same email, click on add, and it generated it right here. Let's put that there, and let's pull out again from the yellow and pop it in right there. Okay, so this campaign has 3 emails that go out. The first email after 5 minutes, the second after a day, the third after 7 days. You see how easy that is? to have a traditional email autoresponder using Mautic. It's simple. And then you can do different things based upon whether someone actually views that email or not, because you can attach off of here. You can say if someone read this first email, that must mean they're engaged in your content. So what we would do is we would go down here to where it says decisions. So let's see, the decision is if they open an email, and we'll say first email. Okay, and then we're gonna link that here. So they look at this, and then if they look at the email, we're going to have this thing happen, or if they don't, it's going to have this thing happen. Now, what's important to note is that this right here has nothing to do with your second or third email. It just has to do with the first email. Nothing's going to stop this first email from going out. Okay, so if someone opens your email, you could have them send another email to them. You can update their field with some information. We can add a tag. So you might want to click on right here. Let's see. And we will add a tag. Let's call it interested. Hit enter. Click on add. And then we link it. Like this. 1:00. So what this is saying is when someone's enrolled in this campaign, after 5 minutes, they're going to get the first email. If they view that email, we're going to add this tag, and we know what the tag is. It's called interested, and we can do something else right here entirely. Like maybe if they don't look at the first email, let's take them off of the campaign entirely. So you can choose right here, change campaigns. Actually, I've never used this option. So let's call it remove from campaign, and we'll remove it from this campaign right here and click add. And then we link it up. Oh, actually, what we have to do is we should put a timer. We need to say right here, we'll wait. So if someone hasn't read the email after a specified period of time, so let's say after 7 days, let me click on update. So what's happening now in this campaign is the first email goes out after 5 minutes. They get that first email. If they look at the email, they immediately get this tag. If they don't look at the email after 7 days, you remove them out of the campaign. However, the logic of this might not work entirely because 7 days is this campaign only takes 7 days to run. So I'm just giving it to you as a demonstration of how to set up your traditional email automation autoresponder using Mautic. Hey, if you like this Mautic video, please give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions, go ahead and leave them down in the comments below, or head over to my website and you can leave a comment there. Pretty good about getting back to you in a reasonable period of time. If you're new to Mautic, I've got a full installation video on how to install it the right way. So anyways, thanks for watching this video.